Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Naveen and I'm part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. In this episode, we will learn about the Wi-Fi-aware protocol. Google recently launched a new developer app called WifiNanScan, which uses the Wi-Fi-aware protocol to allow users to connect with others and send messages without the use of internet or through Bluetooth. WifiNanScan app is designed as a research demonstration and testing tool for developers, vendors, universities, and more. Let us look at the abilities of this app before diving deep into the Wi-Fi-aware protocol. Using this app, users can send a document to a printer without the need to first log on to the network. The app lets users reserve a restaurant and view its menus while walking by it without an internet connection, whether it's open or closed. The app also helps to automate and timestamp the check-ins and roll call in a school. Using this app, users can replace their physical ID such as a driver's license or passport with mobile identification. This helps travelers to easily pass the airport security, customs, immigration process and traffic police without requiring to present a physical ID. With this app, it is possible to obtain a distance measurement with a precision of about 1 meter with phones up to 15 meters apart. Developers, OEMs, and researchers can use this tool to validate distance range measurements, enabling the development of peer-to-peer ranging and data transfer, Find My Phone, and context-aware applications based on the Wi-Fi-aware protocol. Now let's take a closer look at the Wi-Fi-aware protocol. Wi-Fi-aware enabled devices will be able to detect and constantly send and receive messages with each other using wireless networks before making a connection. This communication is done using internal Wi-Fi networks, so no mobile data or network or internet bandwidth will be used. This allows devices the ability to continuously transfer information back and forth with no need for human interaction. Wi-Fi-aware networking works by forming clusters with neighboring devices or by creating a new cluster if the device is the first one in an area. This clustering behavior applies to the entire device and is managed by the Wi-Fi-aware system service. Apps have no control over the clustering behavior. Apps use the Wi-Fi-aware APIs to talk to the Wi-Fi-aware system service, which manages the Wi-Fi-aware hardware on the device. The Wi-Fi-aware APIs let apps perform the following operations. Discover other devices. The API has a mechanism for finding other nearby devices. The process starts when one device publishes one or more discoverable services. Then when a device subscribes to one or more services and enters the publisher's Wi-Fi range, the subscriber receives a notification that a matching publisher has been discovered. After the subscriber discovers a publisher, the subscriber can either send a short message or establish a network connection with the discovered device. Devices can concurrently be both publishers and subscribers. Create a network connection. After two devices have discovered each other, they can create a bidirectional Wi-Fi-aware network connection without an access point. Wi-Fi-aware protocol is built in with all smartphones running Android 8.0 and above. Wi-Fi-aware network connections support higher throughput rates across longer distances than Bluetooth connections. These types of connections are useful for apps that share large amounts of data between users, such as a photo sharing app. Wi-Fi-aware is also known as neighbor awareness networking. The Wi-Fi Alliance says that the continuous discovery of compatible devices is made possible without putting undue strain on battery life, with multiple Wi-Fi-aware devices forming clusters that share a common heartbeat signal that contains information about the availability of nearby services. Basic information such as location data, sensor readings, and services in close proximity can also be exchanged between devices bidirectionally without having to connect to an unfamiliar device. Then, if approved, applications can then quickly transition to a higher bandwidth Wi-Fi connection via a Wi-Fi Direct or standard Wi-Fi connection. Users can decide what they want to see through subscribe operation and what they would like others to see through publish operation, and opt in or out for disclosing identifying information on an app-by-app basis via their privacy settings. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.